is your First Alert 5 weather with Jessica Van Meter.
Welcome back. We've got some low clouds and some areas of fog this morning. That's the view from Memorial Hospital, or at least it would be. We've got a lot of clouds and fog kind of obscuring the view there. A lot of that lingering through the lower elevation areas this morning along I-25 between Colorado Springs, Pueblo, all the way out towards areas of the plains. A lot of improvement as you head up towards Woodland Park, areas of Teller County. That improves very quickly. We're already seeing some sunshine across areas of Teller County. Lower elevations, though, fog, clouds, certainly the case. Here's why. We've got temperatures mainly in the 80s along the I-25 corridor, 56 degrees right now in Colorado Springs, 59 degrees in Pueblo. Now, overnight, our temperatures have cooled down into the 50s, and we've gotten closer to our dew points, that measure of moisture in the air. Dew points at 54 right now for Colorado Springs, 57 for Pueblo. So as our air cools and we get closer to that dew point, more air condenses. So we get more cloud cover developing and more areas of fog. Now, as we go throughout the morning hours and warm our temperatures and get further away from that dew point, we'll see our skies improving. But right now we do have that cloud cover not really showing up on satellites, a little too low to the ground to get picked up for right now. As we go throughout the day, we'll see improvement because we have high pressure in control over areas of the Rockies as well. So that'll suppress a lot of development that could potentially happen for today. Keep us on the nice side. Remnants of Gordon moving up areas of the Mississippi River Valley, bringing a lot of rain to the Midwest, especially right along and just north of the Ohio River Valley. Already a lot of flood watches, warnings going on with all of the rain, several inches for some areas expected over the next 24 hours or so there. For our area, any rain today, it's going to be very minimal. This is our intenser model, tends to overdo things a little bit, showing the chance for a shower mainly around Pikes Peak, and then also the wet Sangre de Cristo Mountains could see a little bit of activity through the late afternoon, evening hours, even areas right around the Palmer Divide. Chance to see a stray shower, but I think most areas do stay dry for today. Temperature wise, pretty close to average. We'll be in the 70s around Colorado Springs, 80s along the Arkansas River Valley. Should be pretty nice once we get rid of the cloud cover we're seeing this morning, and again we'll work on that through much of the day. So 70s for today. We'll be back into the 80s around Colorado Springs tomorrow. We'll keep that 10% chance for a PM shower or thunderstorm in the forecast for tomorrow for most areas. After that, we're getting dry and even warmer, back into the mid 80s starting on Monday, upper 80s heading our way for the rest of the week, along with mainly dry conditions. A little bit of summer heading back our way again. In Pueblo, 80s for today, upper 80s tomorrow. Chance to see a stray shower or thunderstorm through the second half of tomorrow. And then after that, we are dry and we are hot. Temperatures back into the 90s starting on Monday. Canyon City in the 80s for the next few days. Small chance to see that stray PM shower or thunderstorm tomorrow. Aside from that, we are looking dry and hot back into the 90s by Wednesday and Thursday. Woodland Park, we're in the 70s for the next several days, getting close to 80 by the middle part of the week. Those higher elevation areas, slightly better chance to see some of that PM shower and thunderstorm activity today, tomorrow, and then even into Monday after that, looking dry and very summery.